Hey everyone, today's video is all about skin texture. This is a question I get constantly on social media, both in the comment section under my YouTube videos, as well as just like on my Snapchat and Instagram as well. And it's something I've touched on previously, but I really wanted to dive a little bit deeper today to talk about really the reality of skin texture and also how to get around to using great skincare products, which is the primary piece that we're gonna talk about today, as well as with your makeup products. First and foremost, makeup adds texture to the skin. You're adding an extra layer of product on your skin. It is going to age you in a lot of circumstances. It will bring out pores, things like that. Today, we're gonna talk about minimizing that as much as possible, but you need to have realistic expectations. So light texture on the skin is something we can really reduce, but deeper concaved scarring or very raised acne, that's something that makeup will help even out, but it's not necessarily going to take that down. In other words, that area that's raised will always be raised. Under this video in the description, I've shared some of my favorite skincare products for those of you dealing with texture issues. Exfoliation is always key to reducing texture on the skin and getting rid of all those dead skin cells. Also, moisturization, even if you have oily skin, is an absolute essential. Seriously, I can't stress the importance of skincare enough, especially if you're dealing with texture issues. In the past, I've had countless clients that'll spend and spend and spend on foundation and makeup products to fix their skin, but they won't spend a dime on skincare. And here's the thing, skin that's well taken care of doesn't have to be perfect, but skin that's well taken care of accepts makeup much better and it makes the makeup look much smoother. And I'm surprised I haven't seen more videos about this on YouTube, but it goes beyond skincare too. Your skin is the largest organ on your body, but it's the last to receive nutrients. So if you're not getting enough vitamins, you're not getting enough water, it will show in your skin. Drink lots of water, and dark leafy greens are actually really amazing for the skin as well, because they improve elasticity in the skin, which makes the skin look more lifted, tighter, and it just makes it look smoother in general. Now, when it comes to makeup, silicone-based primers are absolutely the best at filling in pores and smoothing out skin texture. And I have a few favorites here. First of all, you'll notice the Clinique Pep Start, which was also in my skincare list. This sort of blurs the lines between makeup and skincare because it is a moisturizer, but it does have that dimethicone base that's gonna smooth out light texture on the skin. For those of you that want something that's a little bit more heavy duty, the Smashbox Pore Minimizing is still my favorite primer of all time. There are some drugstore alternatives to this. I know L'Oreal makes one, NYX makes one, but at the end of the day, I've tested this one over and over and it never disappoints. For foundation, my current favorite is the Immaculate Liquid Powder Foundation by Hourglass. But at the end of the day, you want a foundation that works with your skin to reduce texture. And whatever your preference on foundation, even if it's a drugstore brand, it's the application that really matters. So again, you want to create the thinnest layer possible. I've actually fallen in love with beauty blenders lately. I don't know why. For the longest time, I never used sponges. And now for some reason, it's all that I use. But a dampened beauty blender or even a beauty blender with a little bit of argan oil on it will really help blend that foundation out, make it look much more natural. A really great way to test the texture of a foundation is to apply it on your hand. Now, we've talked about this before. It's not the best place to test for color, but your hand has so much texture. It's a really great place to apply foundation and see if it's really gonna bring that texture out or if it makes it look a little bit smoother. Above all other products, powder tends to bring out texture the most, so it's important to look for powders that have the smoothest feel. And that goes for bronzers and blushes. I always like to touch the surface. If it feels very gritty, it's not something you want on your face. It's gonna make it look very sandy and dry. And this is why I'm a huge advocate of HD powder. I know it gets a really bad rap on YouTube, but when the product is used correctly, it will never ever flash back. Use a teeny, teeny, tiny bit of it, and the second it hits moisture, it turns 100% clear, will not flash back. Urban Decay actually makes tinted versions of those powders called Ultra Definition that I do actually carry in my kit. That micronized texture will smooth out the skin and it's not gonna give you that sandy finish that sometimes powder can give you. So even though I shared some of my favorite texture reducing products, this is not a product-based video. So I wanna quickly recap. One, make sure to get rid of all those dead skin cells by exfoliating the skin. Two, hydrated skin is happy skin. Three, silicone-based primers can actually fill in pores and make the skin look smoother. Four, apply the thinnest layer of makeup possible to reduce makeup texture being added to the skin. And five, silica-based powders are the anti-powder. They actually reduce texture instead of adding it. So I hope these tips and tricks help you guys with texture issues. I know for me, it's 5 rules to live by because texture is the bane of my existence on myself. As always, I hope you guys enjoyed this video and can't wait to bring you a new one next week. Thanks so much.